Hello students, today I'm going to explain about teapot program, which I'm going to read the question. Program using OpenGL to draw a simple shaded scene consisting of a teapot on a table. Define suitably the position properties of the light source along with the properties of the surfaces of the solids object used in the scene. Here the most important thing is in the program is you have to draw a simple teapot, and you should also tell the position of that, and even you should tell the properties of the light source, which are the light sources you are using, and even the solid object and even the table. So these are the main things. One is the simple shaded scene should be there, and the teapot must be there, a table must be there, a light source must be there, and you should define the properties of the surface. What are the surface properties you are using? These are the main things which you are going to use in this program. Now I will going to show you how exactly the output of the teapot. Okay, this is the output of the program. This is a simple teapot program where you can see here there is a wall. Okay, this is a wall actually. This is also wall, and this is also wall, and this is the table. This is the table, and on the table there is a teapot, and this is a table leg is also there. So this is a simple teapot which consists of table, teapot, table leg, and wall. Okay, in this program you are using transformation. Okay, in the transformation, mainly transformation is used where you are translating the object and rotating it, okay, according to your need. Okay, according to your need. We will see this, what exactly is that. I'm going to share the screen. Now, you have come back to the white screen. Now, I'm going to clear this question. Okay, I'm going to clear this question, and I'm going to draw a triangle first. I'm going to draw a triangle. First, we will see a triangle. This is the triangle I'm drawing. Okay, now let's consider, I told you in the teapot program I am going to use transformation. Let's consider for this object, for triangle object, simple object, how can I do transformation on that. Okay, in this, so now what I am going to do this in this triangle is I am going to rotate this triangle. Okay, I am going to rotate this triangle in a fixed point. Okay. So there are two triangles are there. Okay, two similar triangles are there. One is a red triangle, one is yellow triangle. Red is the original triangle and yellow is the rotated triangle. Let's consider rotated angle is some 30. Okay, let's consider this rotated angle is some 30 or 40 degree. Okay, so here I am rotating this. Okay, rotating to in this fixed point. This is the fixed point. Okay, I am going to show it here. This is a fixed point. I am rotating with respect to this fixed point, and original triangle and rotated triangle. What I am going to apply is transformation here. Transformation, one of the type of transformation, which is that rotation. So this is very important. Now I am going to share a small figure for you, how exactly this rotation happens. Okay, how exactly this rotation happens and all. Okay, so here everybody can see the screen here. Okay, see here, there is a first everything, whatever you do in the OpenGL program, everything is stored as matrix. Okay, everything is stored as a matrix. In your teapot program it is 4x4 matrix. Normally it is a 4x4 homogeneous coordinates. It is called homogeneous matrix. Okay, 4x4, so 4x4 is 16. Okay, 4x4 is 16. First, M1. M1 is your original triangle. Let's consider about that triangle, that red triangle. Okay, M1. Okay, first I am going to push that, okay, to the stack. I am going to push, you can see here the first operation here, okay. I'm going to push M1 here. So I'm pushing the M1, okay. First step, M1 will be there. M1 is the first triangle, red triangle. I'm pushing into the stack. Why I'm pushing this to the stack, we will see. After that, I'm taking the copy of that M1. Okay, I'm taking one copy of M1 and I'm applying translate, rotate and scaling. Okay, so I'm taking a copy of that. I'm doing translation, rotation, that is transformation I'm doing. Okay, and M1 is changed to M2. Very important. M1 is a matrix, that is original triangle, red color triangle. M1 is translated. Let's consider I have rotated it. Okay, let's consider I have rotated it. So now M2 is there. M2 is your yellow triangle. M2 is your yellow triangle. Okay, so M2 is changed. Okay, this is in the stack. This is in the stack. So stack, what you have to do after doing that, you have to pop it back. You have to pop it back. Why pop it back? Because this one M2 is in the stack now. Okay, that should be displayed. M2 should be displayed. Yellow also, yellow triangle should be displayed. So you should pop it. Then M2 will come into picture. Okay, M2 will be popped. M2 will be showing that. After M2, M1 will be popped, because the why you are doing push and pop matrix, because you want original matrix as well as rotated matrix. I have shown you two diagrams. One is a red color triangle and one more is yellow color triangle. When you rotate a red color triangle, okay, its original identity will be lost. Its original identity will be lost. That is why I am pushing it into the stack. I am pushing so that I can pull back M1 and show I want both M1 and M2. I want both M1 and M2. M1 is original triangle. M2 is a rotated triangle. So M1, M2 is a matrix. M1 relates to the first triangle, original triangle. M2 relates to the rotated or yellow triangle. This one is a red triangle. So this is the major working. Okay, what major working of teapot program? How exactly push and pop is used? In whole program, we are using push and pop, and you are using GL rotate and translate. We are using GL rotate and translate. Why? Because you are doing this operation. Okay, remember this operation. This is the most important thing in teapot program.